Hello everybody, this is Bigblack420i coming to you again with another video. This video here shows my big old truck that I seem to love so much, which is the Peterbilt 379. And I have my show trailer. So since this here is my show truck and show trailer, I'm going to call this segment here Show Truck Trip. I love this truck. We are right now in Elko, and we're going to be heading to, I believe, Los Angeles. So, without further ado, let's get this thing running. Now, this is going to be a little tricky for me to get out of. Two ways out of here. And right now, I only see one way, two exits. Right. But this will come with its own challenges. See, I'm going extra out of my way to make sure that I can get around these corners wide, because this place is not the easiest to get out of. You gotta deal with the scales. Because if you don't go wide enough, your trailer gets caught in it, and then you get caught and can't get out. So, looks like I got it. I'm using this view because I just like the way it shows the rest of the truck and the landscape around it. You know what I'm saying? It just gives a lot of detail that you don't generally see in most videos. So I want to make sure that I at least get a chance to show that detail. Now, while I get into an accident here. Now, I do know that traffic is eventually supposed to stop. The question is when are they supposed to stop? Damn, he was flying. See, it's hard to tell when to start moving from this view. Because anytime I try to start pulling out... Oh, look at that. It looks like he stopped. position before you can give you a chance to move. It's one of the reasons why I like playing online. But I can't use this truck online, so I guess that's the trick. Now I know that the GPS told me to make that left-hand turn, but I'm just going to just follow the road here. Try to keep things a little simpler. Get past the car. Now, can I make it here? Yep, I'm glad it changed the view. Because I'm actually not going to get out this way. Yeah, I guess that's what it looks like when you're in the passenger seat. I gotta remember that when I add my dual screen. To mention in every video that I make with this particular truck is the sound. Alright, I mean, it's one of the most important things for me with a mod. Alright, or if any truck for that matter, so that's played inside this game, it has to have a good sounding engine. You know, like it all has to be in place. If you're driving something that, you know, the sound ain't there, it's kind of hard for your imagination to go where it's supposed to go the way the game was intended. This one here, this one takes the cake, most definitely. Gotta love that sound too. That's, as a matter of fact, that's one of the prettiest sounds a truck can make for me. It's a jailbreak. Be on the highway, I just travel next to a truck and make sure that he's going downhill when I'm next to him, like behind him, so I can just hear the sound of that jig. And as I said, behind him, not beside him, behind him. I don't want to be beside the truck on the hill because you never know what's going through that truck. Well, you never know exactly what that truck's circumstances may be, so that truck may need space to move. Space, but I'm talking about being behind the truck. I just want to make sure I'm clear with that. Look out there if they want to try to listen. You really need to slow down that much. realize I'm damn near out of fuel. Looks like I'm most definitely going to find the next fuel station as quick as I can, because right now I'm inside the red line. I did not realize that. You know what? I think I'm going to put myself on cruise control just to make sure. Let the computer drive and see if that helps me stretch out my tank a little bit. Wow. I guess I should have paid attention to my fuel before I left. First time I've actually ran this truck down this low. So this is the first time I've actually seen the fuel light actually come on my gauge. I got half a red bar left. I've got to find a refueling station. see, a lot of these gas stations are not designed to have a truck my size coming in here. Because my trailers always catch the curbs going in and out. Alright, that was an adventure and a half. I honestly thought I wasn't going to make it to the gas station. I honestly thought that, but I'm here. So now I'm going to refuel and keep on going, because we still got a whole lot of miles ahead of us. I don't know if anybody saw that, but in my rearview mirror, there was a truck that looked like he came in really hard. For a minute, I thought I was playing online. Now, you see how that car came out there, that Phantom? I did not see that car in my side mirrors. I saw that car from my other mirror, from the nose mirror. So it's really good to actually have that. For those who don't think that mirror is important, yes, that mirror is important. Very important. Okay, I missed a gear. Now I gotta pay the price. Getting stuck at the light. But let that be a lesson to y'all out there playing the simulator or in real life. Make sure you have enough fuel before you leave. Because you end up doing what I just did. Worrying if you're gonna make it to the fuel station. Destination can be seen on the map, so I guess I'm not that far out. Blackjack, anybody? You know, something's funny. I see that sign over there that says Blackjack at the fuel station, but you don't see a building over there that looks like you can do any blackjack. Just a gas station, a store, and maybe a couple of little motel rooms for overnight use. I think they're going to pull me into the weigh station. They're going to pull me into the scale. Let's watch. Yep, told you. Thank you. I'm trying to float through my gears right now. I'm not having a good look at it right now. I can't seem to float through my gears right. I don't know why, but it just won't let me do it. Okay, clearly I hit the wrong button there. Now yes, if you're looking at my rims, you are seeing what you're seeing. Yes, it does look like a rim is a little glitched. The only reason why I kept it because I understood why they did it. Because the rims, so far, I don't see it existing yet. But I've been seeing some of these like larger tires that be on the some of these dump trucks and cement mixers. And I know that some 18-wheelers also share some of these front end tires. And I know that this is what they was trying to mimic. I just wish they fixed the gap. Otherwise than that, it'll be fine. Just know which they fit to. That joke was going to be fun, as I was so talking to myself driving the truck, I guess. That might happen from time to time in my mind. Some of these horror movies, you know. That's one thing I like about these simulators, is that you always feel like that you're actually going on a trip. You know? I mean, some of the landscape may look the same, but I mean, think about it in real life as of what doesn't look the same in some places. You know? I mean, but here, you actually feel like you're actually going somewhere. You can actually let your imagination flow with you. That's what I like. Play a map. Well, a game that can have a map that's big enough to make you feel like you're actually traveling somewhere. Instead of just feeling like you're traveling like a couple of yards or just like across the city and with detail. Here you're actually covering like a whole state. You actually have to build long enough, just enough of your imagination to believe you're doing something. That's one thing I can say about the developers on American Truck Simulator. They got it down. I don't know how they feel about us traffic though, but it seems how the AI seems to treat you sometimes, but you know. In Euro Truck, the traffic is pretty similar, so I won't complain too much about that. But it really helps for them to be a little bit more realistic. Just a little, you know what I'm saying? Just a little. Sometimes happen is the you might hit like an invincible barrier or something. Every now and then you'll catch something and you're nowhere near the guardrail. And because it happens so non-often, because it doesn't happen often at all, it's kind of hard to determine like what town it's you know, it happens in. This way you know like where to avoid. But hopefully it shouldn't happen here. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't mind driving in the left lane. But every now and then, I might have to worry about that little invincible barrier that sometimes catches the front end bumper. I'm pretty sure anybody who's played this game can at least say that that's at least happened to them once. At least once. I'm actually kind of hugging this right lane. I love it. I don't even have to go to the keyboard to do my patrols. I'm sitting inside of a cockpit right now. I initially built the Gran Turismo. What I did is that I made a unit that fits onto my dash that has some switches on it. I'm going to be developing a unit that has more switches in the future, and I will be setting, once I get all the bugs set up, well, gotten out of it, figured out, I'll be actually making a lot of them for sale. So anybody that might have any interest in that, you know, subscribe, and eventually you'll see some of the things that will be coming out, because I'm not just out to make YouTube videos. I'm also out to actually make actual hardware that goes to this game. So everything is still in development stages so far though, but after a while, once everything's been figured out, trust me, you're gonna want to know. Because like I said before, I go for the realism, and that includes everything that I build. It's not real. If I can't get the realism out of what I do, I'm not even gonna share it. If it performs the way I want to, which it will, trust me, you're gonna start seeing it out here on this channel. But that's a ways from now though. Right now, this is just gonna have fun just checking out this game, seeing how it plays, seeing how it runs, seeing what else type of options I can add to the unit that will work proper with this game to just add the realism that much more. Life. I'm actually a real life truck driver, believe it or not. I actually have a CDL Class B with towing endorsement. So, from an actual truck driver's point of view, I can honestly say this simulator is pretty darn close. There ain't too much about this simulator that I can complain about as far as like how it's supposed to be. Most of the simulators actually got it down. Well, most of them could do a better job on the low beam of the headlights and like little necks like that stuff, but overall it's pretty much there. Especially like this right here, how like the highways are lit up with the street lights and all that to see. I mean, seeing like the Manhattan skyline is the prettiest thing that it's one of the prettiest things to me, is to see the Manhattan skyline at night. Seeing the bridges lit up, seeing the cities that you drive past, and it's one of the little magical things to go through while you drive. Gotta enjoy the trip, you know what I'm saying? Gotta enjoy the things that you see. You just driving, just to drive and stuff, I mean, you're missing out. Driving isn't just operating the vehicle, it's enjoying the things that you see around you. I wish I didn't have to go through the trouble of looking so much, because I gotta use a mouse. There are other people who do these YouTube channels that has a little headset. Now me, I ain't all that there yet, you know what I'm saying, as far as getting all the technology necessary for that. I'm not saying that I won't in the future, but right now it's like, I'm not gonna go through all that just to see where to go, but at the same time it would be a whole lot more convenient. See, in real life, the cars behind you will wait, but they don't want to get hit. Last year in the simulator, cars don't care. At all. Gotta make a turn, gotta make a turn. Yes, I made the turn. Beautiful. Now, the park is ready. See, if I have a place like this, you're not really going to get on the first shot. Basically, it's more like trying to get it all maneuvered first. Now, also keep in mind, the steering wheel that I'm using, the G27, I'm not using the small steering wheel that the G27 initially came with. Alright, I actually made a steering wheel to go on it until I met, and that'll hold me over until I got a real truck steering wheel to put on this unit. But having a real size steering wheel to go along with this does help, along with its handling and keeping control. I will say that. I ain't gonna end it. That's just cheap. See, I noticed I've been getting a little lazy before with some of my parking. So even though it might take me a little while, because you all know, you've seen the way I park. You know what I'm saying? I get it in there and I'm pushed. But with something like this, for some reason I feel compelled to put it directly inside the box the right way. Well, everyone, this basically concludes the end of our video. If you like what you saw, please subscribe, please like, and please leave your comments. So in this way, I'll know what to change or what other type of videos to do. As more developments come out with American Truck Simulator, I will be making future updates on the trucks that are coming out with it, because there's supposed to be some trucks coming out in future updates, and I will be doing reviews on all of them. So, Like I said, you want to know what's going on, or if you're just curious on how to do something, regardless if it's shifting or what, anything that has to do with this video, well, anything that has to do with trucking, be sure to let me know, because from a real truck driver's point of view, I'm the one to go to. So, with that being said, I'll see y'all next time. Happy trucking. Thank you.